Well, thank you very much for joining me here on Fooding Around New England with your host, John Riga. We happen to be at Wood Palace Kitchens here at 7 Mill Street in Middleboro, Massachusetts. And I am here with Richard Friermuth.
Very good, John. Very good.
I knew that I'd get that name. Sure, Richard. Richard, you have a company that, well, I've had your garlic salt at my home. I've used it. I'm looking for another jar. And one of the reasons that garlic salt came about was because you had an inkling that there was a niche there.
Absolutely. We've used garlic salt in our family for ever.
Uh-huh.
My grandfather brought this over.
Uh-huh.
The recipe for it, he's been making it his whole life. He passed it on to my mother, who passed it on to me.
Uh-huh.
And I've since passed it to my son.
Oh, my.
However,
oh, okay.
We used to make this as gifts for people all the time, as well as our own daily mm-hmm. use. People would come back with empty jars begging for more.
Mm-hmm.
And many times they'd come back with an empty jar that was bigger than the one that I gave them.
Fantastic.
So after a while, so many people were asking that I just couldn't do it anymore. So mm-hmm. I said no.
Yeah.
People then said, please make it. We'll pay you anything.
Wow.
Then a light bulb went on.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. So my son, who is in the restaurant business and has mm-hmm. some food background, we formed a little company and started to produce the garlic salt mm-hmm. so we could offer it to the public.
Uh-huh.
And that's how Richard's Famous Garlic Salt started. Our company is Cranberry Barn Kitchens,
mm-hmm.
and we're off and running.
And right now, this is the only product you have on the market.
It right? is. It is. Uh-huh. We think it's good to do one thing and do it well, uh-huh. and that's
now,
what we are.
Not that I have to put you on the spot, what makes this a little different than other garlic salts?
You can buy garlic salt in a grocery store.
Mm-hmm.
It will have MSG, it will have preservatives, uh-huh. it will have chemicals in it. Our product is all natural, and there is no MSG mm-hmm. and no chemicals and no preservatives in it.
Oh, there's garlic.
There is indeed garlic.
There's garlic.
That with our,
that's a new jar, too.
Yes, it is.
We'd like to have you prepare some food with us.
I would
be
delighted.
In our kitchen here.
Absolutely.
At Wood Palace Kitchens. They've been kind enough to have us take it from, well, stem to stern. You can prepare some dishes. Mm-hmm. What would you like to prepare?
Today we brought some ribeye steaks. Mm-hmm. That's usually where I like to start with people when I explain it. We're going to saute some fresh asparagus with a little garlic salt on
mm-hmm.
that.
Okay.
And we have some roasted root vegetables, some onions, potatoes, and carrots to do also.
All right, we're going to take a very short break, come back, and start cooking with Richard's Famous Garlic Salt. I'll be back in 2 minutes and to taste. Well, thank you very much for joining me back here on Fooding Around New England with your host, John Riga, and we are here at Wood Palace Kitchens at 7 Mill Street in Middleboro, Massachusetts. And I am here with Mr. Friermuth, and I've got the name correct, I hope. The garlic salt. Richard, you know, I mean, again, we talked about there is many out there in the marketplace, but mm-hmm. It can be used for almost anything. I mean, just
we use it on pretty much anything except pie.
Mm-hmm.
Breads for garlic bread, vegetables, meats, mm-hmm. Eggs, believe it or not, a little on a scrambled eggs in the morning, mm-hmm. no garlic breath. It's a phenomenal
source. When you're at the farmers markets, I'm sure you get firsthand comments about the garlic salt and how people use it.
Indeed we do. Wherever we go for that matter,
sure.
the farmers markets, the exhibitions, people that don't know how to use it want mm-hmm. to learn how to use it,
sure.
and prior customers come up and just tell us how much they love it. Mm-hmm. They use it on everything. We even have a customer that puts it on linguica, which to me is wild.
I
but
was just going to say.
Whatever,
yeah.
floats your boat.
No, and of course you use this sparingly.
Very sparingly. Very sparingly.
Yeah, because I mean, I still have the jar, I mean, that much left, because I found out after I've used it a couple of times, there's salt there.
There is salt.
mm-hmm.
There
and
is salt.
And garlic. I've rubbed chicken with it. I've done vegetables, of course. Now, we could take like these asparagus and
mm-hmm.
toss them in olive oil and add garlic salt to it.
And maybe a little bit of Parmesan cheese over the top would be good, and blacken it in a frying pan, and mm-hmm. it's delectable.
Yeah, we're going to do that with... We're going to bake these off,
mm-hmm.
and let's rub up the steak, and start cooking.
Very good. What we usually advise people to do is start off with a quarter of one teaspoon. Mm-hmm. You can't shake this. You need to use a spoon because you don't want to contaminate the, mm-hmm. the jar, certainly.
Sure.
And then we would just take that and just sprinkle that on the top of, in this case, the ribeye steak. Give that a little bit of a rub. Mm-hmm. And you do this just prior to cooking. And again, just a little bit of a sprinkle.
So this particular recipe was passed on from generations to generation.
Yes, it was, John. My grandfather brought it over from Italy when mm-hmm. he came over in the early 1900s.
Okay.
It has been passed down through the generations until it arrived with myself mm-hmm. And my son now. We've tweaked the recipe a little bit
for sure.
to our liking.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And we started to produce it as we spoke.
Mm-hmm. And there's not only just garlic in here, there's spices too.
There is. That's mm-hmm. our secret blend of spices with the...
I knew he was going to say that. It doesn't say secret there, but I saw it there.
Garlic, some salt, and our blend of spices. Mm-hmm. And that's how we produce this. We do it in small batches. Mm-hmm. We do it by hand, from the labeling to sealing the jars up. Mm-hmm. And my wife designed the label. Everybody seems to love that.
Oh, okay.
So,
and this can be found at retail stores?
We are going into production for retail stores. Mm-hmm. We're in the middle of updating our label with the UPC codes and the mm-hmm. nutritional information mm-hmm. that would be required if we get to the level that we hope to get to. So
oh, sure.
We're
sure.
working on that now.
It's a very excruciating business to be in. And the food distribution business as well as the manufacturing end.
And you would know probably more than most.
I've seen many come, many go. But however, since this is a family tradition,
mm-hmm.
you'll always keep it in the family.
Absolutely.
Yeah. No big conglomerate's not going to buy you.
Well, and maybe next month McCormick's might come by and say, well, here's a multi-million buyout for you. But we'll deal with that when it happens.
Okay. I'm going to put this on high.
Okay.
I'm going to start sizzling the steak.
Sure.
Come back. And talk more about how else we can use this, and especially in salad dressings, too.
Oh, absolutely.
It's
wonderful.
Yeah. I'll be back in 2 minutes and to taste. Well, thank you very much for joining me back here on Fooding Around New England. We are at Wood Palace Kitchens here at 7 Mill Street in Middleboro, Massachusetts, and I am with Richard Fryermill, who is the owner, and along with your son, I guess,
absolutely.
Of Richard's famous garlic salt. We're doing, I know I'd like it medium, maybe? Is that getting...
Medium? We better give it another few minutes.
Oh, okay.
Or a minute, not a minute.
Other suggestions and recipes, you'll find them on your website?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. We have recipes for meats and potatoes. It's great with a little bit of ketchup. Sprinkle mm-hmm. it in the ketchup. It's on your French fries.
Uh-huh.
Scrambled eggs in the morning. Believe it or not, just a pinch of that is a wonderful thing to start your day with. Okay. You can put it on pork for Thanksgiving, turkey time.
Mm-hmm.
Take a little olive oil.
Sure.
Rub the turkey breast. And again, just a little sprinkle of the garlic salt on that will be wonderful. And one of my favorites, mashed potatoes.
Oh, definitely. Now, would there be any other spices that you can add to this that would kick it up a notch? Or if you want to use a red pepper flake or something like that?
Not a
yin-yang effect, you know, in other words.
Right. You could do that, but we wouldn't recommend it.
Oh, okay.
We just usually tell people to throw away all their other spices and stick with the garlic salt. You can make it stronger, certainly, by adding more, but...
Okay. All right. The potatoes, you want to bring those over and we'll
sure.
put them on the plate here?
Mm-hmm. Right out of the oven, these are roasted
okay.
potatoes.
Why don't you put it down right here? That's good. Now, maybe there are places where you can find it retail.
The garlic salt?
Yeah.
It is in one store in North Plymouth right now.
Oh, okay.
And that would be Quintal's Fruit
oh, sure.
and Vegetables
oh, yeah.
Market.
Yeah, nice place.
Great little place yeah. there. We will
okay.
be putting it in more.
Are you going to plate this for me?
Sure will.
I'll take a couple of potatoes. I get served well here, I guess. And that's one of the nice things about, you know, cooking. Of course, it brings the family together. It brings people together. It brings son and father.
Absolutely. We have more fun making it and laughing
uh-huh.
as we go. And then the best part for us, of course, is talking with the people.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we like to do.
And being of Italian heritage, this garlic salt can be used in a gravy, sauce.
Stews.
A
nice tuching if you're making. It's great in your meat sauces for your pasta dishes. Salads, it's wonderful with some oil, some vinegar, and again, the sprinkle of the garlic salt over the top before you toss it.
You know, I'm gonna go to my kitchen table. I'm gonna eat this steak and have some potatoes and think of you, Richard.
Good, because we cooked the second one, so maybe I'll join you.
Well, we have a lot of people who would like, I'm sure, around here, at least a little taste anyway. I thank you very much, Richard. And to find out more about Richard's famous garlic salt, get onto their website, which is
www.cranberrybarnkitchens.com.
Okay.
Right. Or Google us at Richard's Famous Garlic Salt.
Oh, okay. Are you on Facebook?
Yes, we are.
Oh, okay.
And like us on Facebook, we'd appreciate that.
Thank you,
John,
Richard.
It's been a real pleasure.
And I guess I'm going to become an old salt of yours, anyway. Thank you again, Richard.
Thank you.
Well, we've been here at Wood Palace Kitchens here in 7 Mill Street, Middleboro, Massachusetts. Thank you, and as always, do everything in good taste.